All right, it's July 12th, it's Saturday. It's around 10:30 a.m. And see these brown spots I have on these beans? These were like Jackson Wonder beans. But you see the brown spots all over those leaves. Again, not being a horticulturist or anything, you know, I know some of the yellowing is from overwatering and such, but we cut that back big time, and we have these brown spots and all this, like, those are purple hull peas, but look at the leaves. Okay. And call me conspiracy theorist or what, but those trees right there are filled with spot, like brown spot leaves. It's a pine oak and it's a red oak. I don't know if it's red oak or white oak. But the leaves, they get here in the garden. And like, just perfect example, right there's one. Probably red oak because the leaves are red. See the spot on the leaves. And that's the majority of the leaves that come off those trees. They come over here into the garden. Unless you have Monsanto food-like products with a congenically modified seed to begin with, it's very difficult, if not almost impossible, to grow good, healthy, and nutritious heirloom type of vegetables. I mean, like I said, when I see that stuff all over the leaves, you know, I mean, that might be part of the plant. I don't think it is, but, you know, again, I'm not a horticulturist. It grows good for a while, and then with my knees being as bad as they are, it's difficult to get out here and do a lot of things. Look at the growth on this. This is a watermelon plant. Look how it's all regrowth, all this. We've got one watermelon over here. We've got dozens of flowers on here. Not dozens, it's probably about 20 or less. Flowers on the vine. And I do see butterflies out here. We've had watermelon, we had the one watermelon, and then we've got what this would be a honeydew. I just picked one off. Another one. Up closer to the southern part of this garden. These are cantaloupe. You can tell by the skin, I grew up with cantaloupe, love it. And I'm not gonna water these because you see the leaves, how they are. I give them liquid fertilizer, protogrow. And it's supposed to rain sometime this week. Today being Saturday, by Wednesday it's supposed to rain. Look at the sky up there, it looks like it's gonna rain, but it's looked like that so many times. We've even had storms coming right at us. And then they just seem to go like right over us going north that way. So, yeah, see the black-eyed peas do that all the time. It's probably not getting the right nutrients in the soil. I'm a lazy, ignorant gardener. I use protogrow from Heirloom Solutions with my seeds are heirloom also from Heirloom Solutions. And one seed I plant, one plant grows. Very few exceptions. This is a straight eight cucumber. I did plant two down there, but again, the soil is not the best, I believe. Because there were things planted there and planted there. And you don't see anything growing out of there except grass. So I would say it's the soil. Take a sample, well, yeah, and go wherever and stick it up your thumb and your butt and then wait. But this is the okra out here. One there, two here, okra plant, green okra. That's a burgundy okra on the left and a regular green okra on the right. And then we have a green okra over there. I pulled off a few pods that are like 7 inches, 6, 7 inches. These all need to come off too, but right now I'm not gonna cut them off. You can see them, have them twist and everything else. And they'll just dry out and they'll be seeds. We got enough seeds probably do about an acre of okra right now. An acre is a lot. So, from this front sunflower, semi-sunflower fence, back to that Monsanto corn there is probably about half an acre. Maybe just over half an acre in length or width, whichever way you want to put it, it is square. So, yeah, but look at how this watermelon is. It was a Waltham watermelon. See how it is right here? Which is, look at the leaves down in there from these damn trees. See the disease looking spread on them? And then look at this here. So it's all fresh. This has all been out here within the last 3 days, 4 days, which is a lot in 4 days. That's about 5 foot. That's about 7 feet, six and a half feet roughly going that way. This here, I'm not sure clear what this is. I've been just pulling this stuff up. I'm gonna try to do it well with my hand on the camera. See, just taking this stuff. I don't know if it's good for the plants or not. I just been pulling it up and throwing it off because, again, I don't know. You know, get mulched into the ground with the lawnmower. I got purple hull peas growing here. I got purple hull peas growing right there. I got the purple hull peas are the big leaves like that one there. This here might be the trail of tears. No, it looks like purple hull peas too, unless they're the same. Yeah, this is purple hull peas advanced further than that one there. But I got about 10 or 12 purple hull peas planted. Because, you know, get a lot of those. It's a very good pea to have. That, I think, is Trail of Tears. Trail of Tears back there. The big, big leaf here, that's a purple hull pea. I'll show you a mature one right back here. You got one here, see the purple flowers on there? That's not why, but look at the hulls on them, you can see. They call them purple hull peas. I picked about a gallon plastic bucket like that of them 2 to 3 days ago. And I'm gonna pick some more here off of that one. There's two here. There's two over there on the east end. They got pods on them. Some of them are gonna still be moist, so I'm gonna leave them on. But by the end of November into September, the heat should go into like late September. See, that's a purple hull pea. I didn't realize inside that cage. I put that cage around there thinking it might have been a different bean. This one here is the Jackson Wonder bean. Everything out here would be like a homestead. You know, you make do with what you have, and that's exactly what it looks like because that's exactly what I've done. Chicken wires, and I break tomato steaks to make fencing posts. Because this is as natural as you're gonna get it, other than the plastic. I don't use any chemicals. Dishwashing soap with water, if they wanna call that a chemical, for insects. Baking soda and water for disease. But like I said, when it gets on this and as spread as it is with these trees out here, it's a losing battle. I could spray these every day. And then they get all wilted from so much water all over the plant.